The Water Planning Council, as many of you know, was actually established 20 years ago by the state legislature. And for 20 years, we have really been working to establish a state water plan. And that came to fruition in 2019 when it was approved by the General Assembly. And what a great celebration that was. But the mission of the council has only begun. We have a great group of people, my colleagues, Lori Matthew from the Public Health Department, Graham Stevens from DEEP, and Martin Heff from OPM, as well as Alicia Charmett and Josh Kanzler from the Water Planning Council Advisor Group co-chairs that are assisting us in this effort. So our mission is to build a water conservation ethic in the state of Connecticut, to maintain the highest quality drinking water supply in the state of Connecticut, ensure high quality drinking water for human consumption, balance the use of water, and identify policy recommendations and implementation items. Virginia De Lima and Dave Ratka and the implementation work group have done an outstanding job implementing the goals and objectives that we have set up and the priorities of the state water plan. One of the highlights of the plan is the water conservation and water efficiency within the state of Connecticut. We lag behind in the water conservation ethic. And as a matter of fact, last week we had a water workshop that many of water rate workshop that many of you attended to look at possible legislation, water conservation laws or incentives, develop an education strategy, review existing conservation programs and identify priorities, to adopt the policies on conservation incentives, review passive conservation savings, evaluate funding, technical support, and training on water system management, explore the models that we have for technical support, and explore incentives for outdoor water conservation measures. And we really needed that. As you know, many of you, is that we were in a very, very heavy drought situation last fall. And we know it's going to occur again. So we have to look towards smart model ordinances for drought control. When we have to work with green industry on buildings and landscaping efficiencies and continue to strengthen our partnerships. It's wonderful today that we're going to have people from the federal government, we have people in the state government, people in the local government to set our priorities and work along with the water industry to make sure we have safe, reliable, affordable, potable water in the state of Connecticut. And finally, we have to look at the governor's executive order 3 when it comes to climate change, that we are really also a part of as we implement the state water plan, that we recognize that climate change impacts the drinking water supplies that we have in the state of Connecticut, that it impacts the water quality and quantity of water within the state of Connecticut. So we have to work to continue to focus on priority objectives for protection and drinking water sources, address drinking water safe daily yield, raw water quality, and assure sustainable drinking water supplies and systems everywhere. It's my honor to be part of World Water Day, United Nations World Water Day. As I was driving today down Route 8, I say this all the time, I drove along the Nautic Valley in the beautiful Nautic River. And I've lived in the valley, as many of you know, my entire life. And I look at the fact that today we can boat in it, we can fish in it, but I also remember what it was like in the 60s and 70s when we used to call it the Rainbow River because we never knew what color the chemical was going to put into that river. So water, I'm passionate about it. I'm passionate about it as it was 20 years ago. And this is just a wonderful day to highlight and I look forward to hearing from the panels and all the other things in the program today that we can't take it for granted. Somebody is dying somewhere around the world right now because of lack of potable water. So again, thank you for letting me be part of the celebration.